फ्रेंड्स, आई एम हियर, आई एम हियर विद सम इंटरेस्टिंग लेक्चर्स. एज आई टोल्ड यू इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट आई विल बी टीचिंग यू C++, जावा एडवांस जावा एंड मैनी लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज, बट दिस टाइम आई एम हियर विद द वेरी बिगनिंग लेक्चर ऑफ द जावा. एंड टूडे आई विल बी टेलिंग यू पर्टिकुलरली इन दिस वीडियो दैट what are the features of Java, and not all the features but very important feature of the Java, and how to compile the program, how to run the program, and after that how to compile and run with NetBean, and how to compile and run with command prompt. So in the beginning of this lecture I am telling you there are so many features of Java, that is Java is a very easy language, and Java is distributed, Java is platform independent. But when I am asking in many classes, when I am teaching, that what is the feature of Java, then everyone is answering Java is platform independent, Java is platform independent. But when I am asking that C is platform dependent or independent, then he is saying yes, C is platform dependent. When I am asking why C is platform dependent and Java is platform independent, then very few students of the class are able to tell this thing, that why Java is platform independent and C is platform platform dependent, and how to prove this thing. So just focus on the screen, and I am coming back to my so today here I am going to tell you that why Java is platform independent and dependent. So very first I will be covering why Java is platform independent. So I am saying to you that there are many computers, okay. I am saying that on this I am running Windows, you can say Windows 10. On this I am running Linux. On this I am running any other OS, okay. Now I want to tell you that if I am compiling a program of C program will be compiled. I am compiling this program. After compilation I will be getting what type of files? Actually I will be getting two type of files, .obj files and .executable file. Friends, now I am having three type of files. First is .c file, second one .obj file, and third one .executable files. So if I am copying this C either on Windows or on Linux or on other OS, this time I am copying C file to every place, then this will be working everywhere. If I am copying executable file, this time I am copying executable file to every place. This time I am copying this executable file, you can see it. Then this executable file will not be working on each OS. Or you can say excluding on which it was prepared. On which it was prepared. So if it was prepared on Windows, it will be working, executable will be working on Windows only. If I was prepared not executable or any other type of file on Linux after compilation, then that will be working only on Linux. That type of file will not be working on Windows. Now, this is the case of C. Now, I am going to explain the case of .java file. Same type of systems are there, three categories. You can see the first category is Windows 10, second category is Linux, and third is other OS. Now there are three categories of files. One is Java, second will be .class file, two categories only. So if I am copying Java file, naturally this will be working everywhere. But if I am copying this class file to any OS, this class file will also be working. When class file is working on each OS, you can see in on each OS, this concept is known as concept of platform independency. Means after copying, but executable file is not working on each platform. If I created executable file on Windows, then this will be working only on Windows environment. Okay. If I created that on any other platform, then it will be working on that only. If I created some type of file on Linux, after the compilation, that will be working only on Linux. If I am I created some type of other file on other OS by the compilation of C, that will be working only on that place. So this executable file is fully platform dependent. But when I am creating after compilation, I am creating this dot class file. This dot class file is working everywhere on any platform. But there is a very big dependency in the creation of class file. Now you have to see the difference properly. Particularly, this is my hardware. This is my OS and this is my dot executable file. This is the case of C language. Now what is in Java? This is my hardware, this is my OS and this is my JVM, and above that you will be seeing dot class file. So when we are talking about Java, in Java, whatever program we are writing for JVM. When we are talking about C, then whatever program we are writing for operating system. So particularly when we are writing any program in Java, we are not writing program for any operating system. We are writing the program for what? We are writing the program for JVM. Okay. Now, Java is platform independent, but there is a question that JVM is platform dependent or independent. Java is platform independent, but JVM is dependent or independent. Okay. So I will be saying that you can see it here, it is coming behind me. So you can see it here that Java is platform dependent or independent. So Java is purely platform independent, but JVM is perfectly platform dependent, it is not independent. So this is the concept of JVM, C, C++ and Java. Now in my next video I will be telling you that how to compile and how to run any Java program. So just you can see my next video, how to compile and how to run any Java program in NetBeans and on command prompt. Thank you. Subscribe this channel and just click on the bell icon. Really whenever my new video will be coming, you will be. Thank you.